Hey, so a buddy of mine sent this to me. He's a data miner and he got this back a while ago, and I don't think I've seen too much info covering this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to attempt to break this down in just a generic way where you can understand easily and be prepared for the Grand Arena Championships as they arrive. So now let me break down for you how Grand Arena Championships work so that it's simple and not confusing. The first thing you're going to want to know is that there are different leagues. Leagues are essentially your ranking, like bronze, silver, gold, platinum, diamond. Only in this game, they're going to be calling it bronzium, chromium, iridium, carbonite, and kyber. Kyber being the highest. And you're going to promote through these leagues depending how you do in each event. Now, what is an event? Event is essentially a number of battles you're going to be doing against other players in order to determine how you're doing in the season. Now, what is a season? A season is going to be an amount of time consisting of a amount of events. We don't know how long the seasons are going to run, and we don't know how many events are going to be in each season, but what we do know is that based upon how you do in each event, you will be promoted. The very beginning season, you're going to be starting in Bronzium League, so it's going to be fair no matter what rank you are. Everyone's going to be in the same league, and I'm assuming they're going to match us somewhat based upon GP in the beginning just to get the matches going, or maybe they'll have a more advanced algorithm by then. So once you're matched in our very first event, if you do well, you're going to get promoted to the next league. The top four ranks in each of the leagues get promoted to the next one, meaning you have to be the top four in Bronzium if you would like to get to Chromium. This basically translates to a direct ladder and is the most fair way to match up the game. If you have the correct characters, the right amount of characters, and essentially just a better roster than the person next to you, you will climb past them in the ladder and you will get the rewards you're entitled to based upon how you are doing globally. I can imagine this is going to be very difficult for them to balance. In order for us to all be in the same league and have it be a global ladder, each league is going to have to be instanced either in a shard system based upon when you joined or some kind of GP algorithm range so that me as a 2 million player is not faced against a 5 million player that has every item in the game, and a 800k player is not placed against me just because he happened to roll other 800k players and did well early. Something else to keep in mind is the top division within each league is going to be locked to X number of players. Essentially, Division 1 is locked to 8,192 players based upon your GP at the start of the first event each season. So, in the beginning of your first event, when we start the season, you get matched with people similar GP, and then the top division you will climb to as you beat people within your same GP bracket. And when you get to Division 1, if you beat the 8,192nd player, you will then be the 8,192nd player. That person will fall to the 8,193rd and will then be demoted to Division 2. There can only be 8,192 players within Division 1. This is actually a really good system to have. A lot of companies do this in their competitive games, and it helps balance out the division so there's not huge disparity between like Division 1 and then the bottom division of the next league. One minor problem you might run into is when you get into like Division 2, there can just be a billion people in it, because what happens is all the people from Division 4 and Division 3 are good enough to get promoted, so you all get to Division 2. And in order to go from 2 to 1, it's much more difficult because you have to knock down one of the only X amount of people that can be there. So now you kind of understand the basics of like how promoting works, and we're all going to start in the Bronzium League at the very beginning. You probably want to know, why should I bother doing this, or where the reward's going to be. So what's going to happen is essentially at the end of each event, you're going to be receiving rewards for that. This is, I would assume, similar to how the Grand Arena is now. You're going to receive like some Omegas, maybe Zetas if you're lucky, some random bits of gear, mod salvage, stuff like that. Probably nothing huge. But what's really important is going to be your end of season rewards. This is how you have been doing during the events and as you've been getting promoted, and it's going to be based upon your league and division. So we can very quickly start to understand where monetization is going to come into play. Now, if we think back at the very best peak revenue time this game has ever seen, it's going to go down to the Heroic Sith launch of 2018. Essentially, the Heroic Sith drived people to be competitive, to place within the top ranks in order to get absolutely insane rewards. Not to mention, the main driving force of monetization is by placing us against each other in Squad Arena type of brackets and by making us more competitive with each other in Grand Arena. So I do believe that this Grand Arena Championship is going to have very good rewards, and that you should be preparing yourself for the future by building your roster in the tightest, best GP narrow way you can, so that when the Heroic Sith 2.0 comes out, and in order to get Gear 13, you need to be in the Kyber League, you're ready. Now's a good time to talk about Kyber League. Kyber League is only the top 32 people each season in Division 1, and that's in the Carbonite League. So you have to be the top league in the top division and be the top 32 players in order to get this. Keep in mind, though, that we are going to be in what I would assume some kind of shard system or placed around other people within our GP bracket, so I do not believe it's only the top 32 players in the world. That would be kind of nuts. So the TLDR is essentially the end of season rewards are probably going to be pretty good, and it's going to make you want to make sure that every single event you do counts, that you don't mess around, that you're playing properly. I'm totally okay with this if this does happen. I do believe we need a reason to stay engaged in the game and to very much try hard. I'm to the point where in Grand Arena, I almost don't even care anymore, because the difference for me in like a win is like one Omega and seven generators and a little bit of slicing stuff. It's not enough to matter for someone whose main goal is strictly just to have fun with content creation. Some potential problems we could run into is I know they had tournaments in the past using like ally points and all that, and the biggest issue they had was there's a lot of cheaters, essentially. And unfortunately, I can see this going south extremely quickly if they lock important bits of gear, or just give us tons of really good gear based upon higher leagues. And then there's cheaters that basically dominate those leagues. And since you can only have X amount of players in each division, if there's only 32 cheaters, you know, out of a million that are in your shard or whatever, it can very quickly become a problem. There's other glitches and problems that could happen, but I'm just going to be an optimist and say CG will probably fix all of these out by the time Grand Arena Championships come out, because in all honesty, what they probably want out of this is to look like a genius by giving us a, you know, competitive game mode that also gives you great rewards as well. And then it would be a win-win because we get some additional rewards. We get to have a competitive game mode, and they also get to monetize our gameplay by having us compete against each other. I don't have a problem with that. I think that's fair. You know, it's a win-win. It would also fix one of my other problems, which is that I believe the game just needs more game modes, man. We need more things to do. We need, you know, like a rotating something. We need RNG or procedurally generated base game modes. I want to be able to just kill waves of stormtroopers, sandbox mode, whatever. You know, we need more things to do in the game. And if Grand Arena Championships is one more thing I can do in the game, well, then I will take that with a smile. And by game modes, man, I don't mean this contraband cargo where it's like, oh, yippee, I guess I'm getting a couple shards or something. And you put in your team, you hit auto, you watch it for a couple minutes, and, you know, congrats. In a way, Malak was almost the best event they've ever done, even if we ignore all, you know, the monetization complaints and everything, because it was a challenging event. It had was puzzle. It was actually fun if you weren't, you know, getting stressed out about trying to beat it, which only comes from the aspect that you spend $1 billion to try to get the guy. But it was also a very unique type of puzzle, you know? It was almost felt like a game. I actually missed logging into the Territory War for like the first time ever, and that never happens for me. Normally, I am so gung-ho about playing this game. I think what it is all the legendary events in a row kind of took the mystique out of it for me, and now I just feel like I'm a cow getting milked. Also, why is this ever acceptable in any game, okay? If I've given you over $1,000, why am I always going to get annoyed to put your notifications on? What more could you want from me? Let me hit never. Where's the pack option to buy that? Also, now that General Grievous is done, it would be kind of nice if maybe they added another character in the shard shop for us to farm if we wanted to. It would also maybe help them out a little bit, because I know they don't want us spending our shard shop currency on real high pieces of gear. So they'd probably much rather us be spending it on things like General Grievous here. And I will give them props by saying they did add the slicing, which was nice. And they have the gear 12 pieces on here too. Thank you, CG. I will acknowledge that as a very nice addition. But maybe another character in here, a crappy character. Give us, you know, Kim Adi Munda. Where is that guy? Someone's going to say, you know, don't forget about the Wookiee droid. Him. Well, that's going to wrap it up for this video today. I just want to give you some general information on the Grand Arena Championship. Keep in mind, this is all speculation. It's just based upon the data mine / general leak or whatever you want to call it. General leak. We're going to have to put that in the thumbnail.